Now we're going to see the albinism. Albinism is a disease with depigmentation, usually mutations that lead to decreased production of melanin. Could be decreased in the tyrosinase enzyme, the one that converts the tyrosine into melanin. Well, after multiple steps, what is one of the most important enzymes. So it could be a defect or a mutation in the gene codifying for the tyrosinase enzyme. So albinism, there are two types, the oculocutaneous, ocular type, and the other is the syndromic albinism. In syndromic albinism is albinism with a systemic disease, could be Cheria Higashi, for example. Remember that in Cheria Higashi, the problem is the cytoskeleton of the cells. In these cells is the, that what is important for this video, is that the melanocytes produce the melanin that are packed in the melanosomes. Here, these melanosomes, and this melanosome is going to be passed into the keratinocytes, this keratinocyte. But this melanosome needs to be moved through the cytoskeleton, but because there is damage to the cytoskeleton, this cannot be moved forward, and so the keratinocytes do not have the melanin, and so it's not pigmented. And so in the syndromic type, or syndromic albinism, is albinism due to a defect usually in the transport or the package of melanin into the melanosomes, or the passing of melanosomes to the keratinocytes. Specifically, this from melanosome to keratinocytes is called the Cheria Higashi syndrome, and present with many other things like thrombocytopenia, paresthesias, recurrent infections, and things like that, because the neutrophils also cannot move because of the cytoskeleton defect. So in the syndromic is a defect in the transportation or package of melanosomes and associated to a systemic disease. The ocular type only involves the eyes and additionally presents with nystagmus, a decreased pigmentation of the iris, and decrease in the visual acuity. The oculocutaneous type involves the eyes, and skin and hair, etc. And there is increased risk of the three types of skin cancer: melanoma, basal cell carcinoma, and squamous cell carcinoma. There are at least four autosomal recessive disorders in which the patient can have oculocutaneous albinism. So albinism, decrease in the melanin production, could be ocular type, oculocutaneous type, or syndromic type, that is just associated to a systemic disease and is not decrease production of melanin, but instead decrease transportation of the melanosomes or decrease packaging of the melanin into the melanosomes.